If you're a fan of this show, you know that I am a fan of Thor. And over the years, we have attempted to science just about every single aspect of the Asgardian deity, from how he flies, to how he calls down the lightning, to whether or not a Jedi could lift his hammer, and what would really happen if it shattered. But we've never covered one critical topic, how Thor actually summons his hammer. So let's put the hammer down and figure it out. Ah! Boop. Trademarked. Now, famously, Thor can throw his mighty hammer, extend his hand, and have it returned to him, even if the hammer wasn't moving in the first place and with no apparent distance limit. It's the most magical looking of his abilities, but could there be some science behind it? I think so, and it only involves reshaping the fabric of the universe. But first, what is physically happening when Thor throws his hammer, it slows down, and then it returns to him? Well, even though we can't see it, there has to be some unseen force acting on the hammer's mass to decelerate it and change its velocity. And whatever this force is, it needs to be able to act on the hammer over time, because we see the hammer slow down and then accelerate back to Thor in the movie. So it is traveling with some velocity, and it has some mass, so it has some momentum. Now, when the hammer is summoned, there will be a force put on the hammer that has to act on this momentum over time. Now, eventually, this force will start to take over, and it gets bigger then the momentum over time that the hammer had, and then the hammer is going to start accelerating back the other way. So how this force acts is pretty straightforward. We just need what the force could plausibly be. I'm using plausible pretty lightly here. The force could come from electromagnetic magneto-like powers, but we know that Thor doesn't have these, and we don't know if the fields would interact with the hammer. The same goes for telekinetic-like forces that Stranger Things 11 might have. I told you I'm not shaving my head, I gotta trim. We need a force that not only applies itself invisibly, we need one that fits with what we know about Thor! Oh! I said invisibly! Mjolnir already messes with its own weight, so what about a gravitational force? When you want to find out how much some mass is tugging on you with gravity and you're not going the speed of light, we approximate that force with Newton's law of universal gravitation, which, as you can see, is only dependent on the masses involved and how far they are apart. According to this equation, every particle in the universe is actively pulling on every other particle, just to a varying degree. Even right now, the edge of the universe is tugging on your shirt like it's beckoning to me. Whoa! Whoa, did not mean to. So if you just have your hand open, you, whoa, coming in hot. This gravitational force is the same thing that gives your mass weight as it pulls you against the surface of some massive body. The reason why you only weigh 1/6 of what you do here on the moon, for example, is that although the moon's radius, how far you are away from its center of gravity, is just a fourth of what the Earth's is, the moon is 100 times less massive than the Earth, making this force of gravitation smaller, and therefore you weigh less. How the variables change in this law is also why, if you were on the surface of a neutron star, which is billions of times more massive than the Earth, you would weigh 10 trillion kilograms and be dead. Both of those. Now, what if we considered Thor and his hammer as two particles acting under the law of universal gravitation? Then Thor would throw his hammer, and as it separated itself from him, the distance between them would increase, but their two masses would stay the same, unless the hammer wanted to hit something or not be picked up, but that's a different show. So the only thing that we can change here about this relationship is the fabric of the universe itself. Lightning to me! Wow! And change the universal gravitational constant G, which has units of force included in it. So if we change this, we might be able to summon the hammer back. If some kind of Asgardian enchantment could change the universal gravitational constant, it would give us the invisible attractive force that we're looking for! Where did you get those pants? They're stretchy. I want some. Here's how it might work. Thor throws his hammer, and as it travels away from him, the distance between the two gets larger. But that's fine. When the hammer is summoned back, suddenly there is some Asgardian magic that radically increases the value of G here, the constant, which puts a large and constant force on the hammer, acting to decelerate its mass. Eventually, over time, all of that momentum will be canceled out until it is accelerating back to Thor's hand where he catches it. Catch. Of course, the other laws that Newton discovered are also gonna be at play, as they always are. So any force acting to move the hammer back towards Thor is going to have an equal and opposite reaction on him. So if you throw it and then summon it back, he's also gonna be pushed towards the hammer as the hammer is pushed towards him. The Earth isn't perfectly spherical, look it up. The same is true for any two bodies in space. The Earth pulls on an incoming meteor just as much as the meteor pulls on the Earth, but we don't see the Earth move out of orbit because the Earth has a gigantic mass, and so that force doesn't accelerate it. It's negligible. Even though there is an equal and opposite reaction, I think this explanation still works. Thor would just have to brace himself. Back of the envelope, if Thor threw his mighty 19-kilogram hammer, according to a Marvel trading card, around fastball speed, maybe 40 meters per second, and wanted to summon it back to him after it traveled 10 meters or so, then Thor would only need to resist a pulling force of 1 kilonewton, or a few hundred pounds. I think that's definitely doable for the God of Thunder. So, how does Thor summon his mighty hammer? Well, because we know the hammer must be messing with gravity already in some way to make itself unliftable at will, I think the two objects can change the universal gravitational constant between them and create a sufficiently large, invisible attractive force that will bring the two objects back together when summoned. Maybe they both just kept the Asgardian constant in their universe, and so whenever they are separated, they are brought back together by this constant. The scientists on Earth, though, might call it a new force of nature, the Thorce. They might even call it magic, but we'd call it science because, well, you know, I already said it. Oh, yeah! The surface gravity of a neutron star is so large that if you were somehow teleported to its surface because you couldn't approach it or else you'd hit it near the speed of light and explode, unlike anything ever has exploded before, you would be flattened by the gravity until you were just like a sheet of atoms covering the surface. Your body would be disassociated and distributed across the surface of a neutron star in the flattest human cake ever, which is gross. The all-new Thor has come to Marvel Puzzle Quest. An all-new event, the Sakaar Arena, inspired by Marvel Studios' Thor Ragnarok, is now live, so get in on the action. Play in this all-new Versus event where you team up with Thor in these 20-person, 90-minute lightning rounds to earn ISO 8, Standard, Elite, and Heroic tokens. And speaking of Marvel Puzzle Quest Thor, have you checked out our Team Nerdist video where my dad is actually Odin? Yeah! Check it out, and I hate lightning noogies. Download Marvel Puzzle Quest now for free on the Apple App Store, Google Play, and the Amazon App Store and Steam. Thank you so much for watching, Greg. If you want more science, follow me on Instagram and Twitter at SciFile. They're both the same. And check out ProjectAlpha.com where you can watch the space program for premium science content. And check out Musquatch if you want a very silly show about a very serious man. Thanks.